Hello, I'm Dr. Lee. Welcome to Practical Pain Management. In this video clip, I'm going to share an image training over a more complicated case of CM-guided lumbar transforaminal steroid injection, especially subarticular approach. In the lumbar spine, disc pathology can be subdivided into four regions: central zone, subarticular zone, foraminal zone, and exforaminal zone. Also, lumbar spinal stenosis can be subdivided into central, subarticular, and foraminal type of stenosis. Subarticular and foraminal pathology occupy most of the unilateral radicular pain. Let's close look at the subarticular type. The subarticular area is defined as a space between the facet superior articular process and the posterior vertebral margin. The paramedian sagittal scan shows narrowing of subarticular space and impinges the nerve root. On axial T2 weighted image shows focal protrusion of paracentral disc and narrowing of subarticular space. Foraminal area is defined as a space between the pedicle and posterolateral vertebral margin. The lateral sagittal scan shows dorsal root ganglion swelling and narrowing of foraminal space. On axial T2 weighted image shows hypertrophy of facet joint and swelling of dorsal root ganglion. There are several needle approach techniques in relieving radicular pain. At this time, I'm going to share the subarticular approach. In the subarticular method, I place the needle tip right under the pedicle. In subarticular HMP or stenosis, I recommend the subarticular approach selecting one level below. For example, at L4-5 subarticular pathology, I choose L5 subarticular injection. Also, I can choose the infraneural approach at the same level. For example, L4-5 subarticular pathology, I take L4 infraneural injection. How about foraminal stenosis or lateral type of HMP? I prefer the infraneural approach at the same level. For example, there is a foraminal stenosis L4-5. I like to select L4 infraneural approach. But I also select the subarticular approach at the same level. For example, L4-5 foraminal stenosis. I commonly use L4 subarticular injection. This model demonstrates the subarticular needle approach. Look at the nerve root, pedicle, and needle pathway. This picture is a look-down oblique view from the posterolateral side. This view corresponds to the CM cranial tilt oblique view. This picture is a look-up oblique view from the posterolateral side. This view corresponds to the CM caudal tilt oblique view. Let's go to the subarticular approach technique. I prefer to use AP and oblique CM image guiding technique to reduce radiation hazard and save procedure time. Good practice depends on high definition of CM image. In prone position, set the CM on AP view. There are many variations of lumbar curvature and individual segmental vertebra. Set and tilt the X-ray beam cranial or caudal direction to parallel the inferior vertebral end plate of upper vertebra of the target segment. For example, for targeting L5 nerve root, tilt cranially to align L5 inferior end plate. Step 2. Give ipsilateral oblique view to visualize the pedicle, superior articular process, transverse process, a junction of superior articular process and transverse process, and safe triangle. Advance the needle until the needle hit the intertransverse ligament. Step 3. On AP view, advance needle along the medial inferior border of pedicle. The needle shadow has to move on X-ray AP view to the same ratio as the needle went in. If the needle shadow has not advanced enough, the needle tip must be in the wrong way. Step 4. Infiltrate the contrast media on the live fluoroscope. If I watch a good contrast pattern, I inject a steroid mixture. I use triamcinolone, 50% of dextrose, and 2% of mefivacaine. Sometimes it is challenging to observe a safe triangle. I commonly use a contralateral oblique image. I'll explain more detailed anatomy later. Step 7. If I'm not satisfied with the contrast pattern, I add an adjuvant target. I add ipsilateral facet joint injection in case of foraminal stenosis and ipsilateral interlaminar epidural steroid injection in case of subarticular stenosis. Let's go to the practice. She has left lumbar radicular pain. She had to bear severe pain during the MRI scan because the supine position worsened her pain. Her simple X-ray tells disc narrowing at L5-S1. The oblique image makes me guess complicated procedure because the high iliac crest obscure safe triangle and narrow window. T2 weighted image shows foraminal stenosis at left L5-S1. Facet saturation image shows high signal intensity of end plate and disc space at L5-S1. Axial image shows left lateral protrusion of black disc, and oblique sagittal image shows L5 dorsal root ganglion swelling and foraminal stenosis. True AP image shows indistinct inferior end plate of L5 and narrow window. Cranial tilting motion provides well demarcation of the line of inferior end plate of L5. Next step is turning to the oblique view. I should rotate the CM until I find a suitable injection window. Visualize the inferior border of transverse process, lateral border of superior articular process, and its junction. Hold the needle with long forceps. I carefully select the skin puncture site on the CM guidance because it is one of the most crucial steps. Advance the needle under the CM guidance. I am still holding the needle holder. If the needle went enough, I hold the needle with my bare hand and control the needle meticulously. It is time to stop moving. Let's turn to AP image. If I feel an intertransverse ligament, I stop moving. Then I return to AP view and move forward the needle further and crawl under the inferior surface of the pedicle. I was not sure my needle was located the proper location. Please identify the pedicle and superior articular process and needle. I was not satisfied with the contrast pattern, so I select the facet joint at L5-S1 at the same level because she has foraminal stenosis. I chose the inferior recess approach. Phew, it was a tough case. Thank you for your attention.